Can you hear me?
A little bit. Stand up, speak right into it like you mean it.
I want to take this opportunity to thank everyone for coming here to support such a great organization and also for giving a few minutes of your time to hear my story. My breast cancer journey began in April of 2010. I was 26 weeks pregnant with my third child when I noticed some redness in my left breast. After an aggressive course of antibiotics, my doctor sent me to a breast surgeon who immediately performed a biopsy. I remember leaving her office thinking that was an odd course of treatment because I was so young, but whatever. The devastating news came a few days later. I had breast cancer, a rare and aggressive form known as inflammatory breast cancer. The next few days were a whirlwind of testing, imaging, and finally starting chemo. Yep, that's right, I started chemo while I was pregnant. But not to worry, my son Samuel is a healthy, happy 2-year-old with him and his two sisters keep me constantly on the go. I had a tremendous amount of support from family and friends, and of course humor to keep me going. My mother spent the majority of her summer helping care for me as well as my 3 children, essentially keeping my household afloat. My sister, who was still breastfeeding her son at the time, began to pump extra milk so that Sam could have the benefits of breast milk even if it wasn't for me. Anyone who's ever attached themselves to a breast pump knows the value of that gift. I learned that it really does take a village to raise a child. Here's where the humor comes in. After my mastectomy, I was fitted with a breast prosthetic, which my 2 girls then became obsessed with. One afternoon, I was getting ready to go, and I couldn't find my boob, so I asked my daughter, who was 3 at the time, if she knew where it was. She said she put it in the garbage because it was broken. I said, how do you break a fake boob? She took me over to the garbage can, and there was the fake boob with my nipple chewed off of it. I was speechless because, really, what do you say to that? After several attempts, my wonderful husband found some type of adhesive that would stick to the silicone. The boob was back in business. In the fall of 2012, I was just finishing up with all my treatments, and I was overcome with a feeling of helplessness. I was expecting to feel joy and excitement for finishing. In an effort to try to lift me out of my funk, one of my good friends, Kara, suggested that I walk in Making Strides in Cincinnati. Thus, Aimee's Army was born. As soon as I told my husband what we were doing, he immediately sprang into action, emailing family and friends for donations. And what happened next, we never could have imagined. In addition to the generous donations pouring in, family and friends began to sign up for the Army and make arrangements to come to Ohio and walk with us. I started to feel like I was making a difference. I realized while I couldn't change my situation, I could potentially help others who were going through the same thing. On the morning of the first walk, I was amazed at Aimee's Army, who had started out with 3 walkers and a goal of $250, now had walkers for about 35 walkers that came from as far away as New Jersey and Florida and raised just under $14,000. In the 2 years that Aimee's Army has been around, we've raised $22,000 for Making Strides Against Breast Cancer. With the monies raised, I feel like we've made a difference for breast cancer survivors. Making Strides has been around for 20 years, and since then, the fatality rate for breast cancer has dropped by about 32%. Coincidence? I don't think so. American Cancer Society has been involved in almost every major research breakthrough in treatment for breast cancer in recent history. I'd say that's a pretty good return for your investment. During my cancer journey, I've also found several other amazing resources that Making Strides helps provide for. Hope lodges all across the country that provide people a free place to stay when they're going to doctors out of town, a 24-hour hotline, and a beauty program designed for women going through treatment. While breast cancer is not the battle that any of us chooses, Making Strides Against Breast Cancer helps provide a vast array of support to help ensure that we're victorious. If I can mobilize a team during my treatment, just think how easy it is for all of you. I really hope that you can become involved so that we can have a world with more birthdays. Thanks again for giving your time and support to this great organization.